What are light beams? Generally, if you fill a room full of dust or smoke and switch on a torchlight, you could see the torchlight illuminates the section of that smoke, which forms a nice, interesting light beams. You see this phenomena naturally in the atmosphere and even in the wild also, when there's a lot of dust and the light, sunlight passing through the sections of the trees, and then you see the interesting light beams formation. So how to achieve light beams is what we are going to discuss. And we are exclusively discussing volume scatter node in the Blender application. Hi, my name is Vishal. Welcome to the Rains Academy. And we are going to explore the volume scatter node in this particular video. Let's get started. So let's explore the volume scatter in this particular scene. First, let me show what I've got in the scene. I have background plane. I'll be deleting that background plane. I've got a couple of lights. I'll delete both of them. And if you see right now, I've got a model and I've got a camera here. So I select the camera and I just want to navigate the model in the camera view. So what I have to do is I will press N on the keyboard and then go to the view tab here and then just click on the camera view and then use the scroll wheel and other navigation shortcuts and nicely position this object in the center. Now once that is done, I press Shift A and then create a spotlight. And then position that spotlight above this model here. Now I have got a light and a model and nothing else beyond that in this particular scene. Now once that is done, I select the world here and then open the volume and then connect the volume scatter node from this particular place. Just click and then just select the volume scatter here. We can also do this just by right clicking here on the line and then choose horizontal split and then split the viewport into two panels. Now, once that is done, I will change the panel. What we have here is a viewport. I just wanted it to be the shader editor. And then once that is done, I'll just select the world. And then you have the world tab coming up here. And we got the surface and we got the volume. And we got the surface connected with a background node. And we have the volume node unconnected. So what I have to do is, open that, just click and then select the volume scatter node, which brings up this volume scatter here. You can also press Shift A and in the search you can type volume scatter node and then connect it. Okay, so you could see that in the shader section and then we got the volume scatter here. And then once you brought that, you just connect that and then connect it to the volume, and that simple it is. So once I have got, I change my render engine to cycles and then just switch to the rendering here. And you should able to see you got the volume scatter effect with the spotlight what I've created. In the volume scatter, I've got the color option. I can just select the color and pick the color what I want for the volume what I'm getting here. I just reset it. And you got the density. You have the density value which multiplies the amount of volume what you have right now in the atmosphere. So I just reset that back to one. You got the anisotropy, it is the light direction versus the camera direction. How this volume should respond is what we have in the anisotropy. And contrary to that, we can also use this volume scatter on a model. How do you do that? Let's say I just wanted to create a sphere. So press Shift A, go to the mesh, and I just created torus. So this torus looks too big and I'm going to scale this. And then I move this torus above here. And then I just wanted it to be rotated slightly like that. So this looks like a model, okay? So I select the torus here and we got the material section. And then we create a new material here, okay? And then you got the principal BSDF defaultly connected. So we got two sections very similarly what we have it to the world. So we got the surface section, we got the volume section. We can bring this material to the shader editor. For that, I change this to the object. And then you should be able to see the principal BSDF. Now if I change the color, the object color is changed. As I told, I just wanted to connect the volume scatter node. So I press Shift A in shader. I choose the volume scatter and then connect that volume to the volume. And what I have to do is I have to remove this surface and the object turns that way. As I keep on increasing the density, I could able to see the volume here. So I can play with the scattering. So I just increase the density so that you could able to visualize the volume in the shape of the model here. I can change the color and you should be able to see the volume is in that particular color. It's not rendering as a real 3D, but it's rendering just like an air volume filled with dust or something else. So we are getting the volume in a particular geometrical shape. That's what we are doing here with the model. You got any questions related to this, please let me know in the comment section. And if you like the video, just hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. Thank you very much.